Hello everyone and welcome back to Command and Conquer Generals, the second mission. Hong Kong, China. Basically they've taken over the commercial centre. And that looks stable. Definitely. Completely fine. Yeah. Why do I get the feeling that this bridge is about to collapse or something? And the fact that I can hear beeping. That beep? Is that my alarm clock? Hang on, let me check my alarm clock. Oh. Oh no, 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 I was right. Boom. Oh. Made it, please made it. Oh, thank God. The bulldozer's made it. Okay, so they've attached charges to the bridge and blown it. Cloud plastic. Right then. We have the mission? Let's do this. So we get Gatling turret this time. Okay.
We have big plan.
We want to get a reactor up and the barracks up for anything. Right, these guys head to the front. I have a feeling the enemy is going to come from this direction. No, not you.
I build for China.
Ooh. I want to be able to use my general's abilities. You want to head into that building and garrison it? Also head into that building. Excellent. Right, you want to construct a command center. Meanwhile, you want to construct a supply port. There we go, we want it aimed in that direction. Where did you come from? Ooh, forgot about that TNT charge. Right, we got one of the guys going there, we got another guy building that. Okay, so far everything good's happened. What we got? We've got options, nothing blue here. Yeah, why not? Mines? Ooh. We probably don't need them. Okay, right. Build a couple of supply trucks.
We will live in prosperity.
Okay, now we want one of these things to make some feeling gap. What is this? Oh, we can enter it. Well, that's interesting. Okay, let's start bombarding. What do we want to get? I guess start bombarding the main center. Want to get radar, actually. How much did that cost? Only 500, it was worth it. Come on, I want to see the big boom boom. Nice. That was rubbish. Oh god! We have an enemy attack. I'll repeat. We have an enemy attack. Incoming now. Start construction on a couple tanks. Well, you probably want to go here and get a Gatling truck. Well, you guys are just stupid. And then we'll take out the toxin tractor production facility. Okay, that is definitely going to be a priority. We can send a couple of tanks over there. Right, what do you want to build a Gatling gun? Okay, good. Okay. Do you want to build a Gatling gun? Well, you don't really get a say in the matter. It's red, that means that's good, right? Please, 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 please don't deploy GLA like rocket launchers or something. Oh! Red Guard. Nice. The People's Army. Okay, excellent. The infantry annoy me, but as soon as we get this Gatling gun up, it won't be long before we start, like, opening them. Get a couple tanks as well. Send a tank to support them. An endless... What? Oh. Blooming... Whee! Not reaching them. Okay, let's send a... God's sake. I don't want to build a defense there, because I'll have to take it down inevitably. Okay, go and support this the Gatling tanks. While they're not that powerful at first, they can get extremely powerful. They're like the quad cannons. I remember the GLA had the quad cannons, which were similar to these, except that you could upgrade them by running them over parts. And I remember them just being ridiculously overpowered, because they would basically go straight through aircraft. Like, if you had helicopters, you didn't have a chance. If you had aircraft that were subsonic or that didn't have stealth abilities, chances are you wouldn't be able to breach their defenses. And they were just OP. Especially against infantry, and even tanks were, in some cases, ruined by them. There we go. See, it doesn't get that quick now, but in the next upgrade, he'll spin quicker, and I'm pretty sure you can purchase something that allows a 25% quicker rate. Either that or it's, like, extra damage. Actually, we probably shouldn't blow that up, because it'll result in there being poison everywhere. And I have no interest in destroying my tank before they get on target. I also have no interest in leaving this tanker truck here. For God's sake. Need that. Yes, all of our tanks leveled up. Well, now we know who's, now we know who's going to stay behind and blow up the bunker. Run! Oh god. More of them? Run! Rip. Oh yay, more reinforcements. Do we just get these infinitely? That seems a bit overpowered. I think we're nearly ready to attack. We definitely want to send a dual attack. Actually, what I might do I'll send a bulldozer back there. We can build a Gatling cannon back there. Possibly send a bit of armor with it, you know. Ooh, been promoted. Sweet. Get repair and get that. That costs 5? Jesus, I think we can send 2 units of infantry as well. We'll send a rocket soldier and an ordinary infantryman. Right. This is going to be good, I can tell. Look, there they are, there's the shells. Right, there we are. Where do we get to? Ah, we got the Drossel there, I see. Right. So what we can do, this is their supply source, I think. Come on. Come on. Okay, you go home. We need more reinforcements. 8, 9, 10, 11. Come on. Come on. Yes. The Gatling turrets are here. Let's get another one up. Ooh, do we have enough power? We don't. Right, quickly, get a reactor up and go running. Pushed it a bit too close there. Want a few more Battlemasters. So, alright, one more will do. One will do. Right, let's get infantry into the vehicle. We can send some reinforcements. I think these Gatling the only reason why this Gatling turret is here is because I want to choke off their supply path so that they can't sort of get any advanced units. Okay, how are we doing with this? We're filling up one by one. That it just mows through everything. We're also going to send this guy back, so I don't want to lose a dozer. Are these guys full yet? No. Still got 6 more to put in. Okay. I think we're ready to attack now. Yeah, you're not, mate. You're quite. They said the same thing about the Titanic on the night it died. Our Red Guard is too pro. They're too cool for school. Right, come on. Let's attack. We need to get in there and start shooting them. Okay, right. Load of infantry, but. Oh, hang on. Don't you guys have like an option to use a bayonet or something in close range? Despite being armed with only small rifles, these Red Guard are effective. Definitely gonna be using them more often than not. Is it now? Okay, you go back to base. Okay, here we go. Let's go rescue this guy. Retreat, retreat, dude. You're too important. Send the lorry back. Oh, he made it. Alright, you guys. This guy's like, thank God. I've been here for years. Let's take out these guys. This is so effective. I love how that thing was gone before it even touched my men. Okay, here's the final place. Actually, no, pull back. Actually, no, yeah, destroy it halfway, and then we're going to finish it off with an artillery strike. Pull back, there's an artillery strike! Oh, look, the flamethrowers are here. Flay him! I just did the artillery shells hit in the background. Yes! You are victorious. Mission complete, guys. I'd thank you all for watching. If you like this video, leave a like, and if you're not subscribed, do consider subscribing, and I will see you next time. Goodbye. It's really gorgeous jam. We've been learning about the three gorges dam. Biggest dam in the world, biggest hydroelectric dam in the world. Something like 2,500 megawatts. 2.5 gigawatts. There's just a flame tank in the background, just killing them all, trying to survive. I have a feeling I know exactly what we're going to have to do. It took so long though. The dam was one of the most impressive targets China had ever had. Yeah, objective. Fine. Do it. It's the only way. Meanwhile, stop building the base. Oh, there goes the dam. They've used the enemy base as well. And boom. Excellent work. The enemy base. I see. They said the exact same thing, I think that's quite funny. Okay, right, quickly, get a base up. Right, where are they car- ah, oh, I see, right. Ooh, mines? Good. I like the sound of those. So we've got mines, yeah, cluster mines, interesting. We got artillery barrage, 24 shells, damn. And we got the artillery barrage level 2 as well, right. That's currently in the middle of construction. After that's done, I want a supply center construct. I'm pretty sure that they are just a few remains. You're done. Going. Definitely think mining this area. I definitely think mining this island would be a good idea. Okay, get two more trucks, because why not? Alright, next we probably want to get a barracks up and get another one of these. Oh, okay, that's done. Right, where's the... I'm going to estimate and I'm going to bomb this area here. Oh, good choice. They're waiting, see, the water's beginning to drop, I see. Oh, it's dropped again. But hopefully... Is it dropping at the rate I think it is? I don't think it is. Oh, well that's a good thing. Okay, next we want a war factory. We actually... Okay. See, when the Mimfrey come over here, they're gonna run over those mines and die. And also, I want to get my flame tanks up there, creating a flame barrier. And I want to get possibly a few infantry up there. Ooh, this is dropping quickly. Alright, let's get this up and running. The Air Force Command. The Air Force Command was. I remember the Air Force Command being so good. Yeah, chain gun upgrade. Hell yeah. Right, okay. Let's get these guys back up here. I don't think there's going to be any more attacks. We destroyed the base. Ooh, got a lure. You get a bunch of infantry. Get inside this troop crawler. We need to replace them. Oh, nearly done. It's nearly reached the level where the GLAs can cross. Okay. 1,200 each. Were they always that expensive? Could have sworn they were never this expensive. Where's Black Lotus? I swear she can like hack into enemy supply centers. A warm welcome. Yeah, the only warmness they'll be getting in my welcome is the warmness of the lead as it spills from our Gatling guns. Well, you see, at the end, the enemies, there are... Ooh, clear mines. Why would we want to clear mines? See it now. They're going to be running at us, and we're going to make sure that they don't ever get to our base. I mean, these mines should hopefully ward off this squad of infantry, because the bomb is worrying about... Oh, surely they can cross now. Can my tank cross? Yeah, my tank can cross. Yeah, here they come. Ooh. All you do. You're making the situation worse for yourself, mate. You're not helping. Right, I want to get a firestorm. I want to get a bunch of these MiGs. I want to have some tactical air support. Preferably, I'd like to have two blocks. We actually just about ran out of power there. To be fair, I was surprised that any of them got killed. Oh, and the scorpion's dead now, so now these infantry are going to get killed. TP infantry. Oh, what the? Why are these guys injured? Oh, yeah, because we bombed this area. I think I might deploy a cluster mine there. And I might send my units across the bridge. Captain Dojo, why not? I think it's Dojo. It said something on the comm about Dojo. Right, let's drop a mine there. Oh god, these guys coming con. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Hurry up. Fly faster. Get one more MiG up, and we'll get one of these. Come on, hurry up, MiG. Right, see, the good thing about these guys, when you get enough of them hitting at the same time. Okay, so let's take out this thing here. Let's take out this bunker. GNA's killed everyone. Well, that's a bit brutal. Right, we want to start bombarding this area. I reckon here's a good place to start. Because it reveals more of the map as well. You want to construct a new reactor? Well, you don't really get an insane amount of it, yeah. I swear we're like, yeah, we're at the very limit of our power, that our power would take us to. So if a power plunk, if our single power plunk is destroyed. Excellent, okay. It's okay, let's build another one.
China will grow larger.
The reason why I want all these 8 MiGs is because it means we can take out pretty much any units before like they get a chance to kill us. Oh my god, they're building up in the town. But we've managed to destroy this area. There's a bit of a minefield here. Lucky our units don't trigger them. Those mines are really good. I'm surprised they were that effective. They were that effective. Right, so we've got one more unit coming here. I definitely want to get some, I definitely want to get this upgraded. And the black napalm. I want to get the black napalm and I want to get chain guns. Because chain guns are going to be most effective, frankly. Oh, you retreat, man. You're nearly dead. No, you ain't got no chance yet. Need to replace the tanks that were lost in that battle. Okay, this is the what I wanted to do. Right, let's get these guys in. Let's finish off this building. Also, how's that supply part doing? Primarily. Oh, look at that! This is gonna be good. I can already tell. what I like. Creates Firestorm. When units walk through that, they don't come out unscathed. This guy, this tank's only out for a second, he's lost a bit of health. Oh, these guys are gonna land, rearm, and it doesn't cost me a dime. Meanwhile, we can upgrade to Black Napalm, which will make our tanks much more effective. Okay, you know what, I've had enough of this. Going guard over here. Yeah, definitely. So this is definitely going to be a more effective. Because he's going to fly over here and they're just going to kill everything that comes into the area. And they won't get all the units, but certainly be effective. Okay, they just wasted all their missiles on like a unit of infantry. But it has started a firestorm. Excellent. These guys better start dying. And they'll keep relanding, rearming, and heading over. So we can definitely succeed and get a bunch of units over there. Oh, I don't want them. I want the Black Napalm upgrade. Because the planes actually use napalm. They have napalm bombs, I think. Firestorm, yeah. Let's drop a shipment of mines. Here's a gift for you. Oh, yeah, definitely a good idea. Ooh, this is their supply area, is it? Well, I think we might as well stop them. Okay, good. This guy's coming over now. Good thing is, we got looks. It doesn't look like there's any enemy anti-air troops up there. They spotted the minefield. Just turn back. Oh, this tank has no idea what he's headed in. Or apparently he does. Oh no, he's on a patrol. I don't know if he's set patrols yet. That guy got burnt, blown up. Oh, Black Napalm! This can be effective. Oh, look at that, it's purple! Right, dead. See, at this rate, we won't actually need a large military, because we can just have our, like, air supports. So that's what, I think that's what the US would have, if it sold all of its infantry and ground troops and just got sold its reserve army and reserve military and such. It's got a large air force. It wouldn't need a big military because its air force would just own. I mean, yes, you'd need troops to like. I mean, guerrilla warfare would definitely. I think the tactic with the US, if you were fighting the US war, because I'm British, would be a guerrilla warfare because their troops aren't as well trained as the British Empire. No offense to any Americans, but our empire specifically trains our troops to be the best in the world, the best standard troops. Whereas the US is more focused on sort of having a big amount of troops. And the same applies to Russia and all that. Which is why I think the best tactic against them would be guerrilla, because their troops wouldn't be prepared for an ambush. They would be prepared for a firefight, because obviously they have air support. But if you were to, say, get a sniper up 10 kilometers away and, like, intercept them, I don't think they'd be prepared at all, because obviously they'd have to take time and, yes, they got stuff like the A-10, which has infrared tracking. It just wouldn't be effective immediately, and if you can sort of do hit-and-run attacks, it kind of takes the point out of the A-10, because it's designed as a close air support. And the US is really very reliant on outside oil supplies to run. How effective is this Black Napalm? Okay, very effective! Because apparently the tanks aren't actually getting through. Oh, come on, I want to give my troops something. I want them to be at least slightly leveled up. Okay. I know it's wasteful, but I'm gonna bombard. Okay, yeah, it was wasteful. So, Alright, here comes the escort in. Oh, slightly effective. Kill a worker. And we've revealed more of the map now. I think the base is definitely getting close. I think the next step will be to move these guys over here. Move these guys into the town. Get them to defend the town. And these guys are driving right through a napalm strike. And they're just going to get owned by my tanks, because they've got a red guard, which means they get more damage and speed, I think. a weird noise. What are you doing? You sound ill. The good thing about the napalm is it's really effective against infantry. And tanks as well, because they're missiles, they're not shells. I think this is how we're going to do it. Just slowly building up our forces. Look at this, I mean, it's like, these guys are on 24-7, like, look at that, they're landing, taking off, and being carried. I wish I was one of these guys, one of these MiGs. Oh. Something exploded! Well, that was effective. Okay, we've got, oh no, we haven't, those guys are just returning to base. Because apparently we've still got a load of guys to kill. Ooh, this tank convoy is looking tasty. And by tasty, I mean they're looking hungry. And by hungry, I mean looks like they want to eat a napalm missile. Did you enjoy that? No, you want more? But be my guest. We got another two for you. Oh, is that enough? Oh no, he wants more. He wants more. He wants dessert. And instead, he's just gonna get air supported. Oh, we lost the unit. Well, that's a shame, isn't it? Okay, well, let's drop a shipment of mines right here. Ooh, we're getting close to the base. I can tell that this base. We can bottleneck them now. We have a chance to bottleneck them. No, I don't. What? Okay, I've come to a decision. We're going to defend this area. By approaching, do you mean bombing? Because our MiGs are making short work of any enemy unit. Oh, so that's the end. The Three Gorges Dam is dead. Which is, you know, a shame. Because Three Gorges Dam is a really good power source. Okay. What is this? Why is there no enemy? Why are we not getting any units? Where we? Oh no, we just finished up the queue. I like the flame tanks better than the Gatling tanks. I did say they were good, but it will build an order of six Gatling tanks and three flame tanks in the next order, because the Battlemasters are only good against the Scorpions. Although, in all fairness, we're facing a lot of Scorpions. Oh. That's effective. That is also effective. These guys are just leveling up. These guys are really high level now, like look at them, most of them are at level 1, and some of them at level 2. Eventually they're all going to be at level 3. This is what you really want on the longer sort of skirmish modes. You want your units to have leveled up. This guy's coming in now, yeah. This is what I love about Garbo. Oh, that building's gone now, so that'll make it a lot easier to scrape this. I love the little secondary explosion. This game has really good graphics actually for being 2006? Where's the manual? What does it say? When was this? Yeah, must have been. Okay. Right, we're probably wasting time now, so. Oh, look, nope, there's a bottleneck again. Why is there a bottleneck? I thought I told this to stop sending all of them over there. Few tanks that do get through, just not this guy's. Oh, look, there's a one guy. I feel sorry for this man. He just doesn't deserve the amount of shells that are coming his way. Neither does the enemy that they're getting anyway. Okay, let's go. Let's just attack. I'm bored now. Getting boring. I don't even know if I've stopped recording the last episode in this one. Oh no, an enemy unit. Is that guy still alive? Oh no, do not. Black napalm is very effective. You've noted their attacks are right, that's. This is effective. Right in the middle of their base. It's not going yet, I wanna wait. Yeah, let's send the units in now. This feels unfair. This doesn't feel fair, the amount of units that I've got. I've noticed our forces have become significantly smaller actually during this battle. We only have about, what's that, we have 8 tanks. Oh no, we've got 4 more flame tanks incoming. And the poor battlemaster here who's facing up against 2 scorpions. Oh, he got one of them. He damaged the other one. Now it's just a case of waiting while the big fires come in. Let's start bombing them. I mean, we've got a minefield set up here, so any units that like exit just gonna get boned. Got, yeah, this building's dead now, it's just been napalmed. That infantry man just got annihilated by our MiGs. I'm not even gonna question what the MiGs were thinking of shooting both their missiles at him. This guy's about to get also annihilated by the 4 more. Yeah, right, let's go in, let's finish off the base. This is what I was worried about here, the Stinger sites. Yep, there we go. The first shot's fired at our aircraft. And a minor one at that. Right, let's go take out the... Let the flame tanks move in. Come on, finish him off. Finish him off. Oh, that was effective. Look at that. Jeez, they lost 245 units. We didn't kill that many. Oh no, but some of them got destroyed when the dam broke. Okay. Alright, thank you for watching. If you liked this video, leave a like. And if you're not subscribed, do consider subscribing. I'll see you next time. Goodbye.